If you work on a MySQL database, there may be a point when you'll need to create a new user. This could be for another developer in your team, or another area of the system, or just to stop using the root account that comes with MySQL. In this video, we'll look at how to create a new user, how to give it the permissions it needs, and creating a connection with the new user in MySQL Workbench. Let's get into it. The first step is to log into the database as a user that has the privilege to create new users. You can use the root account, as I've done in this example, or another account if you have one with privileges. Here we can see MySQL Workbench, and I've logged in as the root user. To create a new user, we run a create user command in the SQL editor here. First, we add create user. Then we add the username we want to create, which needs to be inside single quotes. Then we add an at symbol. Then the server name we want to create the user on. In many cases, this can be localhost. We then add the words identified by, and then we specify the password for this new user inside single quotes. We finish off with a semicolon. Now we can run this command. The user will be created, and we'll see this output in MySQL Workbench. Let's try to log in with this user. To do this, we'll go back to the home screen in MySQL Workbench and create a new connection with this new user. Click Create New Connection. Enter the details for the server you are connecting to, such as localhost if it's on your own computer. Enter the username and password for the user you just created. Click Test Connection. You should get this error here, failed to connect to MySQL. Why does this happen? The user exists, but they don't have permissions or privileges to connect to the database. Fortunately, it's easy to add privileges to a user. We run some commands while we are logged into the root account or the account with privileges. Click OK on the error message and click OK on the connection to save it. You'll be taken to the home screen. Let's go back to the connection where we are logged in as the root user and give some privileges to this new user. Giving privileges to a user is called granting, and removing privileges is called revoking. We want to grant some privileges, and the command to do this is called grant. The command looks like this: grant privileges on database name.tableName to user at server. We know the username and the server. What privileges do we need to grant? We probably want to let them create and modify tables, and view and modify data in those tables. To do this, we can run a single statement that grants create, alter, and drop table privileges to this user. We type in grant create, alter, drop, then the word on. Then we specify the database name. We can specify the individual table names here, but we will specify star so that the user can work with any table on the database. We then specify to, then the user we're granting it to, then at, then the server name. Now we've written this statement here, we can run it. This will give the privileges we've specified to the new user on this database. We could run separate statements, one for create, one for alter, and one for drop, but it's easier to combine it into one statement. Another grant we may want to provide is working with the DML statements on the table, which are select, insert, update, and delete. Without them, the user could create tables but not do anything with the data in them. So we'll write a new grant statement here. This statement will allow the same user to select, insert, update, and delete data on any table in the database. Run this command and the grants will be applied. This is all we need for now. Let's return to the connection for the new user. We're logged into the database. Now we'll try to create a new table, add data to it, and select from it. We can run this create table statement here, which creates a simple table. When we run it, it's created successfully. We run the insert statement, which inserts a row into the table. Then we run the select statement, and we can see the data in the table. So that's how you can create a new user in a MySQL database. We use the create user command, which looks like this, and here's the example we used. We then applied some privileges to the new user using the grant statement to let the new user work with tables. And that brings us to the end of this video on creating a new user in MySQL. If you learned something new from this video, make sure to subscribe to my channel. If you want to learn more about database design and development, visit databasestar.com. That's where I share my best database-related content. Which tip from this video was the most helpful? Was it the create user command that we used, or the different privileges that we added with the grant statement, or something else. Thanks for watching.